Welcome everyone to a new series that I am starting today, which is going to be titled USA Zombies. Oh gosh, I'm still hurting from my running today, so sorry guys, I couldn't give you guys an evil laugh. But you all can imagine a very evil laugh, so let's continue. So anyways guys, I'm actually going to start a real Let's Play today, and before I really start this Let's Play, let me talk about the previous one, which a couple of you guys have given me flack about by saying you cut it too short. I know it's not all of the people, but some people give me flack about privately and publicly saying, why did you cut it so short, and it was this and that. I made it perfectly clear in the title of the episode that it was a mini Let's Play. A mini Let's Play counts as 2 to 5 episodes long, not an actual Let's Play. It was only for me to just dip in my toe, essentially, and just to see if the water was cool. And I found this mod was very enjoyable and very fun to do. So, you know, now that I feel like I know a little bit more experience, and it was also experience, and I also have a little bit more insight about how the mod works, I now can actually go in and actually, you know, dominate. Basically, and I also had to fix some of my sound issues, which, sorry about that. I'm so sorry about the sound issues. They were pretty good. Now, I have played a little bit of the American campaign, so I do know how this is gonna go. I'm not going in halfway, like, what's the word? Oh, wait, I can't say that. So, I can't go in halfway, basically what I'm saying. I can't just go in half-blinded. I cannot just go in and not do anything. So, I actually did plan this out a little bit. And so, when we get into the game, I'll show you guys what I planned out. Okay, we'll get in. Alright, guys, we are on the main map. And now we are going to begin the series. So, like I said, the first thing I'm going to do is group all my soldiers into one centralized position. I'm going to set my population to be influencing craftsmen in New York. And we're also going to be encouraging craftsmen in, what was the state? Massachusetts! No, not Massachusetts. Pennsylvania! Because we need to get these two places. We need to get the steel industry and we need to get the... Oh, sorry. I think I'm coughing up a storm. I might have the zombie apocalypse disease myself. Alright, anyways. Yeah, we're gonna do that right now. Our army's gonna all group up. Technologies I'm gonna be working on are technologies that will help us get to better colonization. So, machine guns, medicine, and state government. Those are the three technologies I need to get good enough colonization to where I could just go in and just go colonize everything once the world ends. So, yeah. Are we about done? No. Economy-wise, we need to be making sure we already tax our people to a lot. It sounds really harsh in the beginning, but we're gonna have to tax our people a lot. I'm just gonna be honest. They're gonna have to deal with a lot of taxes. Gonna actually not tax the rich at all, because I need the rich to build my factories when the population all dies. And... oh, one more thing. The events that America has usually for this game are still implemented in here, so you might see something that is really funny later on that will make you guys laugh. In fact, there are a couple events in America's timeline due to the zombie apocalypse that makes it really funny. Okay? Okay, I think we're ready. Let's do this. So let's see, where's the mysterious plague? There's the mysterious plague, so... should I read it or should I let you guys just stand for it? You know what? You guys can read it, you guys can learn about it, I've always said it one time, and apparently it's starting in Venezuela. Oh, that's not good. That means I'm gonna have to enact my plan a little bit prematurely, which is, as you guys know, if you guys have ever been with me long enough, you guys know I'm an insane maniac for maps. I love the map system in this game, I think it's one of the best things they ever added, and now that I know the zombies in America, I must enact the new Moreau Doctrine. I bet you guys are wondering, what the heck is the new Moreau Doctrine? Well, the new Moreau Doctrine does this! Oh, it doesn't look that epic, but that looks epic! So, basically what the new Moreau Doctrine says is that Once we think that we've given up on humanity and we think that the world is going to end, the Americans will take it into their hands to basically affirm control over the estates of the world. So what we're going to do is basically take immediate authority over a lot of places. Not really in the game, but what we're going to do, hypothetically speaking, because we have a map here and it shows us, that we're just going to first get diplomatic... we're done. Okay, there we go. We're going to get diplomatic relationships with our friends over here. Wait, I can't do it right now. But we're basically... I'll explain it. Basically what happens is that I'm going to let the entire South American continent fall. Like... I'm sorry, South America, but you guys are going to have to fall for the rest of the humanity because I cannot hold all of America without doing some sacrifices. If the apocalypse had started up here, I'd probably be doomed right about now, and I'd have to be coming up with some contingency plans, but luckily that did not happen. I don't have to activate my quarantine yet, my quarantine map yet. So anyways, what this basically means is that I'm going to try to hold the line right here and make sure that none of the zombies that are going to be killing out everyone in South America comes down here. And then once all of South America dies out, we are going to go in and colonize this. Okay? That is the first phase one. Okay, the second phase is when we conquer the rest of the Caribbean and take over as much as we can and retake all of our land over here in the West, or should I say Manifest Destiny will take over that. Yeah! And after that, we will be, going on a little bit of a crazy spree, because after that, the United States has basically decided that if the world has basically ended and there are no old monarchs or governments anymore alive to keep order, it is the Americans' duty and obligation to make the world a law and order place. So what we will do is go on a massive conquest little like splodge, starting in Spain, and then just move all the way upwards. This will probably be colonization and just quickly like colonizing everything, but it makes it look more epic when we have lots of arrows everywhere and we'll just be expanding everything. It'll be a big gigantic colonization up front, but the need for humanity, the need of the many of American, the need of Americans outweighed the need of the homeless and sheltered and anything else you may think of. So that's that. That's my basic plan for the new moral doctrine. I'm basically going to take over the world, summarizing it up, and now that since there's zombies in the world, yeah, we're going to go take over the world when we can. Oh, I should probably start the race for all these things. I'm going to start the race for getting all these colonies over here set up, because we're going to need to set those up, and I'm also going to need to build new ships. Why build new ships? Because we're going to need enough transports to actually transport ships. So I'm going to build some stuff right there. Going to build some in Boston Harbor. 4 or 5. Alright, let's build about 5 each. Okay, you guys can't build it. Let's get into actual good harbors. Washington's a good harbor. Get right here. And there we go. That should be enough to sponsor my entire military, which is exactly what we want. To the Knights of Southern Belle. Or to Southern Labor, to our Knights, I'm not going to go to Southern Labor. And Mexico or Texas? Well, I want Texas to win, because Texas will most likely join our Union if I let them win. Okay, does this really, no, they don't really provide us that much money. It wouldn't be enough to really finance anything, so I'm not going to tax the rich. I'm not going to give my Navy much money, because it's just too much in the beginning. It's just way too much for a country of our magnitude to support. We don't have enough colonial range because we're right now colonizing 3 different places, and frankly, I think we could just relax. Sort of. One thing we do need to do is get an alliance with the USCA, because we need to know how close the zombies are to breaking their government, so we can send troops immediately to go help them. Because as I said, this is the drawing line. This is where we really have to hold them off. And since the zombies spawned in Venezuela, Venezuela is going to fall pretty quickly. I don't know where exactly they spawn, but Venezuela doesn't usually last that long with the zombie apocalypse. It's happened so many times, I can't even tell you people. Really, I'm not even joking. So, yeah, right now we're making good money right now, so maybe I can actually lighten taxes. I should lighten tariffs, actually, because tariffs are the main thing that's going to hurt my economy. Like, if you tariff too much, you are going to kill your economy. I've said this so many times, and I am an anti... Basically, if you guys don't know this, I am an anti-tariff person. I hate tariffs. I will not applaud tariffs in any sense of the way, okay? Let's get to the next stage. It seems like Mexico wants to fight us there. That's gonna be a fun fight right there. Mexicans versus Americans. Right in the Oklahoma City Valley. And it looks like Texas is winning its independence against Mexico. Good for us! Because we want them to win so that they'll join our perfect union, or soon-to-be perfect union, once we conquer the world. You know, all that good stuff. And I'm going to support this can factory because we need to keep our workers inside. And this is why I didn't put any, like, stuff for Massachusetts. Massachusetts already, like, is a good fit. So I'm going to increase the glass factory upkeep. Oh, shoot. The mysterious plague is now on my land, so that means I have to go figure out where it is exactly and stop it. I'm going to start supporting this. I have to support New York because it finances everything I don't have right now. Oh, excuse me. All right. So we have all these new ships being made. I'm going to put them all over here. And where are the zombie risks? Because this is something I didn't do last time, which is I didn't use the revolt map mode to see where the zombies are going to spawn. So let's see where the zombies most likely to spawn. They're only going to spawn in Madden, Missouri. Who would have known? So I'm going to move all my troops right there onto that one spot, because it seems like no other places in the world are really revolting, and just keep my troops right there. Basically, I'm starving out all zombie apocalypse things happening in my own country because I'm waiting for a special event that usually fires, declare a state of emergency. Sure, let's declare the state of emergency. Let's get better land organization and let's become slightly of a dictatorship. Not really gonna care. Apparently, I'm losing this fight. That's only because I didn't increase the colony range. These two colonies are almost done. I hope so because I really need to get this one right here so I can block up the British. If Texas starts to really lose this war, I'm going to step in. In fact, I could step in right now, but, I'm not quite ready yet. I'm not quite ready to get into a Mexican-American fight. I'm almost ready, but not quite ready. Over here, the zombies are starting to spread pretty rapidly. Gosh, we need to end this debate pretty quickly. Okay, fabric factory in New England collapsed. Why don't we just keep that open? Just whatever. Subsidize every single factory. We'll see what that happens. That should help everyone. And Texas is apparently starting to lose. So, oh gosh, I'm kind of feeling kind of weird about this because, oh wait, the revolt list gets down. Oh wait, and there's new colonies. Yay! Create a protectorate. All right, let's get another colony right there. And let's get a colony right there so we can start fighting Mexico. That way, what I'm hoping is what's going to happen is that once we go to war with them, they'll completely back out of both those regions. And let me see, revolt risk map mode is now completely zero. Seems like these people are not mad at me anymore for having zombies in the land. That is a good thing. So, let's now enter in on the Texas side in this war for independence so that we can save their butts from being destroyed. Because we want them to join us. Alright, and let's decrease speed. I'm losing in Oklahoma. I know there's important things happening. And I'm going to be winning there. Create a protectorate. Did we already do that? Okay, we already did. And let's see. It seems like the Texas people are not doing terrible this round, but I need to actually come in and actually make sure that they stay alive. Victory in the USA, and yes, this is the event I was talking about. So everyone, victory in the USA. New tactics and equipment have been developed since the initial outbreak and has helped suppress the zombie outbreak. Traditionally, our men were taught to shoot for the chest because it is the hardest to miss. Since the initial outbreak, they have been trained to shoot for the head and disable a zombie in one go. Likewise, the new standard infantry rifle, SIR, has been developed as a more accurate and semi-automatic alternative to traditional muskets and rifles. On a unit level, unit soldiers were taught to fire with a mechanical precision and alternate with the partner. One soldier shot while the other reloads. Effectively, the alternate repeating rifles and new militaristic tactics have led to an ultimate victory against the zombie hordes. Yes. So that basically means that I have no worries about having any zombies spawn randomly in my land. Which is good. Now, what this does mean, though, is that I have to kind of step up my you know, gains a little bit more. And Mexico's starting to come in a little bit harder. I'm going to start attacking them a little bit stronger. We should be able to destroy the Mexican army right now. They are not very strong, as anyone will tell you in this time period. They are not very strong, and they are not ready to deal with my might. And we gain liberal agitation. That always seems to happen, guys. The liberal agitation always seems to happen. I'm going to go stand on top of their army to go help them with conquest, because I have to, we have to quickly gain all of Texas so that we can instantly do stuff, and they're going to try to conquer Lumbric. I'm going to see if I can conquer this part of San Antonio, and then I'll go after Free Staters. Let them settle. Let them settle, definitely. The Free Staters, we should always let them settle. I'm going to go send these guys to go blast the Mexicans over in Lumbec out of the way. Dang, they got away. Okay, let's go back down to San Antonio. Mexicans seem to be pushing back. Seem to be pushing back to Texans. That's not good. I'm going to be destroying the Mexicans right there. There's a 20 stack right there. That's kind of worrying right there. The second great... And this is one of those events I was kind of laughing at. So the second great awakening, everyone! By the mid... 1830s, a wave of religious zeal was sweeping across the USA, driven by charismatic preachers who preached for the faithful to return to the original preachings of the Bible and lead upstanding moral lives. The movement would spawn several new Protestant sects, lead to debates and schisms within established sects over points of theology and ritual, and reinforce the power and influence of Christian teachings among the lower and middle classes of the American people, a time when religious fever in Europe was decreasing. Yeah, like being attacked by zombies, so I could see why they're not being very religious right now. Okay, and there's a Zombos group right there. I'm gonna go attack it so it can die instantly. Okay, they're dead. Okay, if the quicker the quicker Mexico gets out of this war, the quicker we can end this. Alright, you guys, you done? No, they still want to fight me on. So we're just gonna go destroy this army right here. See if we can gain some more war score. Let's go down here and go fight a big gigantic army. This should be the battle that should end it. Because grim news, whatever. Okay, yep, and I won instantly. And that should be it. They should be going to El Paso. Let's chase them down a little bit. And let them settle. And you guys done? Good. Proceed! Yay! So now Texas is safe from the Mexicans. Yay! Okay, and I'm going to just keep increasing over there, and over here I'm going to make this protectorate, so now I got all of this land. Hooray! And now we just wait. Texas applies for statehood. Like I said, they really want to become a state, so yes, trust in the common man to get it right. We're definitely going to accept him into it. Expand slavery? Heck no! If the CSA is going to spawn this game, I'm definitely not going to support slavery. It's going to weaken me, and so Iowa, and Wisconsin apparently are doing something. Oh, Wisconsin isn't a state yet? Oh, sweet! Wisconsin, I'm proud to present you guys the granted rights of statehood, where you guys will not become a slavery. Yet. Alright, and one more, Iowa. Iowa's somewhere in here somewhere, right? Iowa's right there. There we go. And you guys are also gonna be a state? You guys will not be slavery. Okay, so there we go, and apparently Mexico's gonna want to fight me over these two regions. I hope they don't fight me over this one, because honestly, this will make the Mexican concession really easy. Alright, let's see, okay, so as far as I know, we're a little bit ahead of schedule. The rebels, or the, as I call them, rebels, the Zombos have not reached the Panama Canal and have not been steaming into the USCA, which is a good sign, which means we don't have to worry about major implications of that just yet. What we do have to worry about is the fact that our people are dying from the fact I'm taxing them so much. That is always a worry, but you know, it's just it's gonna happen. I don't know, I usually keep my people in the slums and don't usually like letting them have any power, because then once they get to the aristocratic stage, they usually become like snobs. And so I have to deal with that. And they usually want more stuff, and I don't like to deal with that. People should honestly ask for just water, food, and that's it. That's the way you should play this game. Not in real life, people. I do not express these views in real life, but in the game, this is how you should play it. They should not get anything. And over here, Colorado, I'm hoping they're going to pull out. They should almost be pulling out in here. And the American Methodist Episcopal Church, so established in 1616 as an African-American members of the Methodist community of Philadelphia in the 1830s and 40s, the MLE Church would rapidly expand its membership among both free states and slave populations in the United States under the era of religious revival, providing a spiritual outlet for the African-American community completely under their own control and direction, a new platform for challenging the continued practice of slavery in the Union. And God, our Father, Christ, our Redeemer, man, our brother, oh Lord. Alright, and with that, guys, that was a good way to end the episode. So, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time.